It's time for the Family Feud. Introducing the Strand family. Joanne, Larry, David, Nancy, and Dave. Ready for action. And the DePaola family. Sal, Bernita, Jerry, Wayne, and David. On your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. How'd you get the job? Thank you. Well, thank you, and we thank you for watching us. Boy, I always get such a charge back there listening to our theme music. Isn't it nice to know the big bands are coming back? Here's our winning family, the Strands!
Hello, Angel.
How are you?
I'm just fine, Richard.
You got $6,276. Let's meet these rascals here.
Oh, certainly. This is my son, Larry. My son, Dave, my daughter, Nancy, and our cousin, Dave.
He's brilliant.
He is brilliant.
He's good. He's good.
He's marvelous.
Cousin Dave.
Dave.
You're a newspaper woman?
Yes, I am.
How long? 10 years,
you said? 10 years. And, you know, I have the very best job in the whole newspaper.
What is that?
I get to work with the kids. I supervise the paper boys.
Are you really?
The paper girls. Uh-huh.
How many work?
I'm in charge of about 250.
What do they get paid? What do you get paid for that now?
Well, it varies. The number of papers they deliver.
Well, like what? What would be an average wage?
Well, it's kind of hard to say because they all have different size routes.
Well, what time do they start in the morning?
They have to have those papers delivered by 7 o'clock. They're the best kids in the world.
Well, they
grew
should
up
have
in the rain
got at least
everything.
$200 a day.
Okay.
Hi, Richard.
How are you?
Real good. Yourself?
Did you ever do that?
I did at one time. I sure did. I'm retired.
What did you get paid?
Back then, I think it was about 40 bucks a month.
He didn't work for me.
It all went to the pool hall.
40 bucks a month. And you got to love newspapers. They're all heart. Imagine if they had to deliver those papers themselves. $2,000 a week they'd pay themselves. Good Lord. Child labor abuse. I'm going to get into it. You ever do that?
Yeah, I did. My brother and I both had a route.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Do they give you stars? You can win bicycles if you do all that?
Oh, yeah. Trips to Disneyland.
Sure. My person who does it now, they're trying to see if you can get up on the roof every day. And he's succeeding. He's fantastic. Hi, sweetheart.
Richard.
Are you a travel agent? Is that what I heard?
Right. I'm a manager of Carefree Travel.
Where is that?
It's in Dublin, California.
And so you obviously would know a lot about it. If I wanted to plan a vacation,
sure,
I would just come in and ask you.
Sure. Don't ask me now, though, please.
I'd say I'd like to go to Jakarta, which is now Batavia. Where's that?
It's in Indonesia.
Good
Dutch
girl.
Indonesia.
Very good. Very good. Where else would I like to go? I'm trying to stump you here. No, that's very good. A lot
Thank
of people
you.
Do not know that.
That's my
of course,
business.
A lot of people. It's her business to know what she's paying those kids, but she didn't know. Cousin Dave, do you live near these rascals?
No, I live here in Los Angeles.
Ah, a wise choice, I think. Here's a family going to challenge you. Do I say B. Piola?
Right. Yeah. How are you? Nice meeting you.
Very smart gentleman.
Thank you.
Who have you got here?
I have my wife, Bernita, my son, Jerry, my son, Wayne, and my son, David.
Any daughters in the family?
Yes, we have two girls.
Well, I do, too, but what are the names of yours?
I have a daughter, Nancy, and a daughter, Lynette.
Are they here?
No, Nancy's in Colorado, and Lynette's up in Sacramento.
What is she doing in Colorado?
She's married to a restaurant manager.
Oh, good. Well, when we're up there, we'll pop in. Hello.
Hello.
Have you ever been up there for a meal?
In Colorado?
Yeah.
No, but I'm hoping to go.
You should go there.
She has a baby due any time now.
Ah, then so you'll be a?
Grandmother for the fourth time.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you're a gorgeous grandmother.
Thank you. I have 9 sons altogether.
9? Very well represented here. How are you, Rascal?
Richard.
What do you do?
I'm a student at USC, and I have a part-time job on campus, and I work part-time for KNX News Radio.
Do you?
Yes.
Very good. How are you, Wayne?
Richard, fine.
What's your story?
I'm a police officer with the city of Fullerton, and my wife and I live in Fullerton, and we have almost a 15-month-old baby boy named Chris.
Oh, that's grandmother number one. And right. You, David?
I'm a student at Notre Dame High School in Riverside.
What are you practicing? What are you studying there? Quasimodo, what? I'll leave it. Let's play the feud. Come on. Here we go. 100 people surveyed, top 6 answers on the board. You have to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name a job that requires the utmost concentration. Yes, sir.
Doctor.
A doctor! The number one answer. What are you going to do, Jim?
They want to play.
They want to play, okay. Angel. Very good. Well done.
What do you say? A lawyer.
A lawyer. Looking for a lawyer? Well, I don't like him anyway. That's your first strike. If you get 3 of those, they get a chance to steal. Jerry, a job that requires the utmost concentration.
How about an airline pilot?
Oh, yeah. See if any of our 100 people said airline pilot. I don't understand. That was a goodie. That's 2. Wait.
I'd say a scientist.
You would.
Good. Good. Okay.
Scientist is up there. You're okay. If not, it's your 3rd strike. Strand's then got a chance to steal. Scientist! Not there. Hey, Joanne, look at this.
I don't know. Come on, you
jeweler.
Daughter.
Bus driver.
Jeweler. Accountant.
Jeweler.
Tell me some more. Come on.
Banker.
Need
oh,
an answer.
Oh, boy. I think we'll go with an accountant.
An accountant.
Yeah.
All right. An accountant's up there, you get $43. If not, we're going to give the money to Sal. An accountant! Yeah. Oh, good. Number 3, please.
Yeah.
A gem cutter, you had that. You said a jewel. Number 4. You were in the right area, right? A controller, air traffic. Number 5. That's bomb squad. That's the person who bombs squad. And number 6.
Watchmaker.
Yeah, watchmaker. I would have said a person who dressed Jack Nars, but probably I'm prejudiced. We'll be back. See you, Scott. $43 right there. Nothing here. Come on, kid. Right. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board to this question. Name an appliance you use every day. Yeah.
A knife.
The dreaded... Just called good news and bad news. First, the bad news. Yeah. That's right. By the way, you're in charge of admissions for a college, aren't you?
Right.
Well, it makes me feel secure about the country. I don't know about the rest of you. A knife! That's the bad news. Now, the good news...
A toaster!
There you go. Now, what are you going to do? Play or pass?
Let's play.
Okay, we're going to play.
Explain your answer. That's right. And then we'll... Jerry... An appliance you use every day.
Can opener.
Okay. Good. We'd like a can opener, please. $19 there. Well done. Wayne.
I'll say a blender.
You will?
Yes, sir.
Say it.
Blender.
I didn't say shout it. I said just say it.
Blender.
Very nicely said.
Thank you.
Blender! I'm sorry. Well, I do. I use mine every day, but it just didn't make it. What do you say, David?
I'd say oven.
You do?
Oven.
Okay.
Oven.
Good answer. Right. May we see if there's an oven, please? Number 1 answer. Fantastic. $55 now. 2 answers left. 1 strike. Sell an appliance you use every day.
A refrigerator.
Okay. Good. 1 refrigerator, please. $81. 1 more, and we got it all.
How about a dishwasher?
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
All dishwasher's up there. You got it all. Clean sweep. If not, your second strike. Dishwasher! Okay, Jerry.
How about a range?
A range?
Is it the same as...
Yeah, it's the same as a can opener, a toaster, a refrigerator, and an oven. No, it's the same.
How about a mixer?
No, that would be the same as a blender. Maybe if you stop saying how about before you gave me an answer, you'd come up with a thought that, no, I need now an appliance you use every day.
Freezer.
Freezer. It wouldn't be the same as a... All right. 3 out of 3. Freezer's up there. You're okay. You got it all. If not, it's your third strike. Freezer! Joanne, you can steal it right now. There's $81 up there waiting to be stored.
Oh, come on, you guys. What?
Television.
Can opener.
Television.
I don't want to be number one anymore.
What are you saying? Quick.
We'll go with a television.
Right.
Yeah.
I also want to point out the young man who gave his knife gave his mother can opener. I'm going to come up and check those students out. All right, what did you say? TV, didn't
TV.
You?
TV.
That sounds like a goodie. If television's up there, you get $81 and the big lead in the game. And if not, Sal, you get the money. TV! I don't know. Now, the Strands had two, and they had to make a decision. I think I would have said television. The other one you said was washing machine. Mm-hmm. I do not know what's there. We'll take a look and see. Number 4, plate. Coffee maker. Well, of course, I do use that as a washing machine. I wash Juan Valdez in mine every day. That's some coffee. We'll be back after this. Paola's now $81, the Strand's $43. David, your moment has come. There we go. Well done. The dollar values are doubled right at this moment, and this could decide a winning family, okay? 100 people surveyed. Top 4 answers are on the board to this question. Name an article of clothing people knit. Yeah.
Sweater.
Yeah!
One sweater, please! The number one answer. What are we gonna do?
We're gonna play.
All right. Okay? La-da-da-da. Knife? I'd like a layover in Guam.
Okay.
I know how to talk to travel agents. Hey, tell me something. I see all those ads now. They're cutting 50% off and 57% off. They only did that the moment that English guy, Freddie Laker. Well, what? Doesn't that mean they've been robbing us all these years, these airlines?
No, they have to do it now.
Of course they do. No, otherwise, we'll all ride on Freddie Laker's planes. But
well, I tell you, it's filling the planes. People are going that never would have
gone. Of course, because we can afford it now. Right. A little public service announcement of the day. Well, no, that, of course, and the newspaper kids. I'm going to get them a raise. An article of clothing, darling, people knit.
Boots, slippers.
Okay. We'd like some knitted slippers. Out there. First strike. Dave.
A shawl.
Ah. Oh. Sounds like a goodie. A shawl.
Yeah.
There.
Oh. Great. Okay.
Listen. Plane's coming in. I was just joking about it. Well, I hope they're not going to crash into the building as a symbolic gesture. Name an article of clothing people knit.
I'll say mittens.
You will.
Yeah.
Sure. Love those mittens. 182. There's only one answer left. You've only got one strike. Larry, when I snap my hands, you'll wake up feeling completely refreshed.
Oh, boy. How about socks?
Yes!
Marvelous. lovely. That sounds like a winner to me.
I think I did.
So, yeah. Have you ever knitted socks?
I tried. I got halfway through one.
Yeah. Well, then you turn them into a muff. I know that. Yeah. Hard to make the corner for the... All right, now if we got a pair of socks up there, you got it all, you'll play for $5,000. Last time we played, you won the $5,000. If not, it's your second strike. May we see socks? The only thing that I do not like about this game that I can't have all winners, because you're a marvelous family and you got $81 and some nice prizes, and I wish you could stay around, but thank you for being here.
Thank you very much.
You're a delight. Thank you. You're right. The prettiest grandmother I've ever seen. Good luck. Thank you. You played well. You really did. Thank you. Who's going to play? Come on. Who's going first? Well, then, come here. Go to your room. He's going to get his appliance out, and we'll watch this. At night.
Night. Right, right.
And that's why I will not run. I just gave a little political speech here. Now, your brother Larry is offstage. He has earphones on. He's listening to a lecture by Regis Philbin, the difference between a knife and an appliance you use every day. In all fairness, Regis didn't know the difference. We explained it to him. Now, you know what happens here. I ask you five questions. You give me five answers in 15 seconds. You try and think of the most popular answer. You and your brother Larry get 200 points. You got $5,000, right? 15 seconds. Time will start when I finish reading the first question. Name a pilot on Pan American. Stop the clock.
Richard!
No, I just... I just wanted to see if you were paying attention. No, also, you know, those... It's notorious what those travel agents... Not a word. Make sure that 15 seconds is up there. Here we go. This is for real, okay?
Okay.
Name something people use mostly in the morning.
Toothbrush.
A drink made with water.
Coffee.
A game played on a table.
Cards.
Another word for a hairpiece.
Wig.
A religious holiday.
Christmas.
Turn around. Good job. You said name something people use mostly in the morning. You said a toothbrush. A survey said... 30. Good girl. A drink made with water. You said coffee. Our survey said 13. You got 43. A game played on a table. You said cards. Our survey said 14. You got 57. Another word for a hairpiece. You said a wig. Our survey said 44. You got 101. A religious holiday, you said Christmas, and our survey said 38. Here are the boys. That's
fantastic.
Thank you. Up you go. Here's Larry. Come on, champ. You only need 61 points, okay? Your sister did so well, you only need 61 points. I'll ask the same questions I asked Nancy. You cannot duplicate her answers. If you do, you hear this. I say try again, you give me another answer, all right? Remind everyone, please, the answers Nancy gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name something people use mostly in the morning.
The razor blade.
A drink made with water.
Kool-Aid.
A game played on a table.
Pool.
Another word for a hairpiece.
Wig.
Try again.
Toupee.
A religious holiday.
Easter.
Turn around. Did okay, champ. You're 61 points away. Name something people use mostly in the morning. You said a razor. Our survey said... Oh. Well, I thought that would be good. Toothbrush, though, was number one. You still need 61. A drink made with water. You said Kool-Aid. Our survey said... Oh. Kool-Aid was the number one answer. Oh, you're now 38 yes. points away. A game played on a table. You said pool. Our survey said, oh, 27. Ping pong, number one answer, 11 points away from another $5,000. Another word for a hairpiece. You said toupee. 11 points for the big money. Our survey said, you got them all the number one. Oh, the winner of the Phyllis Diller contest has just arrived. Easter was the number one answer. We'll be back right after this. Lady that ran up, was that your mom?
Yeah. That
what was her name?
Jean.
I was okay, but I was terrified she'd have an appliance in her hand and try and stab me. Hey, we'll see you next time we get together here on the Family Feud. We love you.